Welcome to another mini episode of the Leaders of Finland series, and today I'm going to tell you about the Finns Party Schism. Now, the Finns Party Schism, of course, happened during the time when the Finns Party were part of the Juha Sipilä government, which I talked about in another video. Now, while their entry into the Sipilä government was caused by their very good showing in the 2015 parliamentary elections, it was not their first big win in the parliamentary elections. During the 2011 elections, they had also garnered a very healthy percentage of the vote, known as the Jytky vote. But they turned down an opportunity to be in Jyrki Katainen's government, a fact for which they were heavily criticized because many people felt that they were squandering the votes that they had been given by the general public, which is why when Sipilä gave them an offer to join the government, they were very happy to do so. And although this was a very controversial decision, initially the Finns Party were not so much the center of attention in the government, especially since the Prime Minister was so busy embarrassing himself constantly. In fact, many people noticed that the Finns Party had seemed to have really toned down on their anti-immigration and anti-EU rhetoric during this time. Now, obviously this was because they were just the third party in the government, which was ruled by two rather pro-EU parties. And in fact, some people might have even began to see this as the Finns Party becoming a slightly more wholesome, more acceptable party. Well, there was also one segment of the population that also noticed this change, and that was, of course, the Finns Party base, who were not very happy about this change. In 2017, the leadership of the party went up to a new vote. Timo Soini, who had been the leader of the party since 1997, had decided that it was finally time for him to leave the position, and although several candidates were in consideration, the two most important ones were Sampo Terho and Jussi Halla-aho. Terho was the Minister of European Affairs, as well as the Finnish Cultural Minister, was really pegged as the kind of heir apparent to Timo Soini, and his selection would have meant a continuation of this slightly more wholesome Finns Party that was developing. And his most important counter-candidate, Jussi Halla-aho, although looking like your alcoholic uncle, is actually the only Finnish member of parliament that has ever been convicted for hate speech. So in other words, he was representing the more traditional Finns Party values. And the vote did not go past the first round because Halla-aho secured over 50% of the vote in that round. However, very quickly after that, the members of the Finns Party, who were ministers in the government, decided to pull away, renounced their membership of the Finns Party, and formed a new party, which after faffing about for a little while, came up with the name Blue Reform. As you can probably guess, this was a bit of a shock to people, with some even saying that this was possibly even a death blow for the Finns Party, or at the very least that this particular party schism was going to be bad news for both parties. Although amazingly, the Finns Party ended up not losing any seats, but actually gained one in the next election. And what moral street cred the Blue Reform were trying to accomplish with this split, it clearly did not work, and I get the feeling that the Blue Reform themselves realized what a mistake they had made, because I do remember that during the 2019 election, they started to once again push the kind of rhetoric that was kind of similar to their old Finns Party days. And unsurprisingly, the Blue Reform ended up getting no seats in the government in the 2019 election. So that has been this quick Leaders of Finland video. I'm Hannu the Hande Mäkinen. See you on the next one.